Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here with Assassin's Creed Odyssey. If you enjoy this content, please assassinate literally every other YouTuber so that I have a complete monopoly over this platform, as this really helps spread the good word of my channel. So it looks like we're starting off on Kefalonia Island, and there's a big statue of Zeus here. I know his traditional weapon of choice was a thunderbolt, but let's be honest, his real weapon is that thick booty. This must be my house, and this is me, Alexios. Holding a knife, but also wearing a dress. A look that screams sadistic serial killer. These two thugs come and tell me that some guy called the Cyclops has a message for me, and then proceeds to punch me in the face. Wow, violence against men in dresses is uncool.
Malacca!
Malacca is my favourite word of all time, and the fact he just said it makes me feel instantly connected to Alexios. Of course, I slice and dice these two thugs, as no one wrongs me and gets away with it. Like when my friend with asthma was 10 minutes late to brunch, so I hid his inhaler. Who's laughing now? Not you, Mr. Couldn't make it to the hospital in time. Anyway, this young lass must be my girlfriend. I mean, wait, what? Friend? I don't know, it's ancient Greece. Anyway, her name's Phoebe, and she steals my fruit, which is annoying. Do you know how hard it is to get your recommended 5 servings of fruit a day? I then have a decision to make of whether I kill the thugs or let them go. I do what Jesus would have done and mercilessly slay them as empathy is for virgins. I also dump their bodies in the ocean as a sacrifice to the water gods. This isn't an actual game mechanic, I just like to add my own little flavour to the gameplay experience. I head back to my villa, put on a belt in a misguided attempt to look less feminine, and roll out. Apparently, my friend Marcos has bought a vineyard, and nothing excites me more than Mediterranean agriculture, so let's check it out. I also practice my assassination takedown, and it's safe to say I don't fully understand how to do it yet. Alright, this must be the vineyard. It's vast, I like it. I don't know why this guy is yelling at everyone though, so I do the entire workplace a favour and euthanize him. Sometimes you've got to assert dominance with an iron fist covered in a velvet glove. Except I guess I forgot the velvet glove. A bad use of an idiom there, Pelican. I talk to my boy Marcos, who's got that 480 BC drip. He tells me he's borrowed money from the Cyclops to buy this vineyard, and now he can't pay back the debt. Wow, that's so weird, I thought Greeks were great with debt. Haha, sarcastic economic banter. Also, Phoebe, that young girl from earlier, has been abducted, so I can't imagine the living hell she's going through right now. We better go and free her soon, but first I want to free my mind by doing a little recreational exploring. You can't look after others if you don't look after yourself first. I find a charming little town and immediately decide that I'm going to become what I guess you'd call a dictator. I want to rule the island of Kefalonia by using violence and fear to my advantage. That being said, the good people of whatever town this is are real fighters, which I respect. Unfortunately, their broomsticks just aren't going to cut it against a jack guy dual-wielding actual, you know, sharp weapons. It's quite puzzling, as after the fight, they all just go back to their business like nothing has happened, like there aren't corpses littering the streets. Pretty weird, but I better address the elephant in the room, i.e. the child kidnapping. Now, I'm not saying a kidnapping is ever a good thing, but if you were unfortunate enough to be kidnapped, there are worse places to be taken. This beach is delightful. Phoebe is being held in that hut, and now the game is going to teach me how to be a stealth master. I hide in the long grass and whistle out to encourage the kidnappers to wander close, which they do without question, just like in real life. Wait, if I rescue Phoebe, does that make me a simp, bro? I ain't no simp. Maybe I should just let her be taken away to prove I'm no simp. Unfortunately, I have to advance the storyline, so I do rescue the young lass. We have a brief little chat, and she doesn't even thank me. Wow, first the fruit and now a lack of basic manners? Who raised you? I then find out her parents died, so pretty awkward. Alexios then just lets her run off by herself, which I can't imagine is standard protocol post-kidnapping, but who am I to preach? I just slaughtered the local village. I'm also being tracked by a bounty hunter for these crimes, and so I decide to swim for it. There seems to be a lot of sea life out and about. Loads of dolphins and even a bloody whale, so I decide to try and get myself a boat. I was once out surfing with my little sister and some dolphins came by, and so I didn't say anything and then just screamed shark and pushed her board towards the dolphins, then paddled away quickly. She freaked out and to this day swears it wasn't a joke. So now our entire family thinks I pushed her towards what I thought was a shark so I could escape. It's like, wow, if I wanted to kill you, I'd drown you in the tub, the same way I got our youngest sibling. Anyway, I need to debt collect so Marcus can pay back this evil Cyclops guy. This pot merchant owes us cash but won't pay, so I trash his store to pull him into line. This is what is known as racketeering. He eventually concedes and pays back the money, but I don't like asking twice, so I use him as an example for anyone else who's watching. This is what is known as suppressed negative emotions coming out via video games. On my way back to the vineyard, I spot another pot and decide I might as well attack it too. And look, I'm no master of ceramics, but if the merchant had built his pots this tough, maybe he wouldn't have money problems. Or, you know, be dead. This lady says, "Follow me and I'll give you a surprise," so I follow her, no questions asked. Always follow strangers, kids, especially if they seem sketchy, because they might just give you a bow and arrow. Also, the bodies are just still lying around the town square, which is disgusting. At what point do you complain to council? I quickly use the bow to test if this game is family friendly, and I can confirm that it is. So that's a big relief, as we keep things pretty adorable on this channel. I suddenly remember that this is an Assassin's Creed game, and therefore I can climb anything, which I somehow forgot about. In a lot of ways, climbing is better than sex. The rock's always hard, you can reuse protection, and a mountain can't report you to the federal police. I even climb thick Zeus, because why not? For real, how crazy is it that humans were able to construct such amazing architecture without modern machinery? I love how white people can't fathom that another race was intelligent. Like, nah, Stonehenge and the pyramids were aliens, bro. A nice penis, Zeus. I have to censor it, but it's there, trust me. So remember how there's a bounty hunter after me? Well, the game said I shouldn't fight him until I am a high enough level, but I'm trying to establish an authoritarian government dictatorship here, and having a guy out to kill me sort of undermines that. I decide to fight him head on, and it goes really well for me. A great choice, Pelican, way to assert dominance over the good people of this town that we'll just call our town. Anyway, to take down a thug of this caliber, I'll need a weapon that is the equivalent of an Uno Wild Draw 4 card, so I buy myself a giant axe. Round 2, and you see the issue with a giant axe is the damage circle is massive, so I accidentally chop a fair few of the surrounding civilians too. The next thing I know, I'm on the beach fighting the bounty hunter, a guard, and two women with brooms, and again, things don't go too well. Round 3, and I resort to the meta strategy, running around on rooftops, shooting arrows from safety, and then firing again. Some might argue that this is a bit cheap, but some might also argue that this is the most intelligent thing they've ever seen in their entire life. German physicist Rudolf Clausius might have impressed the academic world with his paper dealing with the mechanical theory of heat, but I just beat a level 5 bounty hunter when I was only level 3, so I mean, you decide who the real genius is here. I can't believe they still haven't cleaned up this mess, it's getting out of hand. Seriously, have some self-respect. I decide to pick up the slack and just clean it up myself, as I take a lot of pride in this town, a town. A blue robe guy then asks me if I could please save Penelope, who's been taken to an island. These boats are giving me Black Flag vibes, I can't wait for some naval combat. Also, don't trust anyone who doesn't beach their boats. Like, what are they trying to prove? They think they're better than everyone. So I sneak into the ruins and go to free Penelope from her prison, but at least all the guards see me. Master of stealth, by the way. I've learned how to kick now, and I really want my This Is Sparta moment where I kick someone off a cliff. The fight rages on, and I kill some big girl who is carrying something called the Shroud of Penelope. And I realize I'm not saving an actual woman, I'm saving a hat. Not a simp confirmed. I'm really not sure who I freed from the cage then, but she seems pretty friendly, so I decide to aggressively hit on her. Always picking the love heart option. This doesn't go well for me, as she brutally rejects my advances. God damn, this game is immersive. Blue robe guy is like, cheers mate, keep the hat. I get it now, it looks like a more traditional Assassin's Creed hood, very cool. I want to look like a Spartan though, so I head down to the local blacksmith who is surprisingly still alive, and buy myself a Spartan helmet. I buy the wrong one though, and look like a peacock. God damn it, what a waste of money. I buy an actual helmet, and finally I can have my This Is Sparta moment. It's so fulfilling and rewarding. I think I finally know exactly how parents feel when they raise a kid and the kid doesn't develop a crippling heroin addiction. Okay, so it's time I go and deal with this Cyclops everyone's been talking so much about. He's posted up in a little coastal town that he's overrun and turned into his own military base. I really admire that, as I've now learned firsthand that it's easier said than done. I sneak into the fortress and, using all that I've learned, skillfully navigate the entire area without being spotted. Nah, just kidding, I fight everyone at once like an alpha male, and every time I have another This Is Sparta moment, my dick gets a little harder. Imagine playing video games without an erection. I also let some wolves out of a cage to help me, but I do this after the fight has already finished, so tactically, very questionable. The Cyclops is busy dunking some poor guy in the water as he tries to interrogate him. I mean, I'm not saying that would be a pleasant thing to go through, but at least you'd be able to stay hydrated. I'm like, hey Mike Wazowski, let's fight big girl, and he accepts. The fight begins, and immediately I just climb up onto a rooftop because I've got a plan. Then whenever the Cyclops tries to follow me, I just kick him off. Did I just turn what should have been a challenging boss fight into a straightforward kicking contest? Yes. Am I going to buy this same helmet in real life so the women want to make sex with me? Yes. Did I forget to have my 5 servings of fruit today? Yes. So with the one-eyed man dead, I go and rescue Wet Boy over here who asks me to follow him. Oh, I'm sorry bro, you didn't just see me fight like 50 guys? You're really going to run without thinking about how exhausted I am right now? I know you've been sitting around drinking water, so you're probably ready for a triathlon, but try and think about others for a change, champ. At least he says I can have his ship and crew as I saved his life and now we can sail for the mainland. I say goodbye to my friend Clingy McGee and this guy who clearly hasn't heard of social distancing. My new friend asks if I want to leave, but I have a little something to take care of first. I buy a new mace and proceed to slay every single person in my town. If I can't be a dictator here, no one can. I just want to be respected by these civilians and maybe worshipped a little bit, but apparently that's just too much to ask. We'll have to sail for the mainland next time, but I'm loving this game. I hope you legends are doing well, stay safe and thanks for watching. A huge shout out to those who support the channel on Patreon, otherwise until next time and as always, stay classy.